of our prime witnesses against Jack Rosewald are dead. Now that leaves us with one.
Yeah, the most important one. We can still get a conviction on his testimony alone, if we can keep him alive.
All right, I'm aware of that possibility. Do you really think we can depend on him after what happened to the other witnesses?
I don't see why not. When he was sent up, Rosewald refused to take care of his family. Now that was an insult, an act of disrespect. He'll testify.
I hope you're right. Jonas, it's important we get this postponement. We've been trying to nail Rosewald's ass to the wall for the past 2 years. I sure hate to lose him because we can't get a witness to the stand.
Well, we'll know in a few minutes if the judge will grant us more time to bring him from Los Angeles.
I find this request highly irregular. The DA's motion of extension is preposterous. And he wants us to permit him a new witness because of the unfortunate accidents that happened to his other witnesses. I protest. This parade of new witnesses could go on forever.
Your Honor, I mean, these unfortunate accidents that this learned counselor is referring to are hardly accidental. One witness was blown to pieces by a bomb in a car. Another witness was shot to death. Now, it's clearly obvious to me, at least, that Mr. Rosewald is directly responsible for this. And these people, victims of his ruthlessness and his willingness to do anything to defy the law.
I must protest the inference that my client had anything to do with these accidents.
Accidents? Guns don't go off by themselves.
Gentlemen, please. Even though we are not in a court, would you please govern yourselves accordingly? It is duty of the court to clearly see that both sides of the case are clearly presented before it. I therefore grant a 48-hour extension to allow you time to bring your witness from Los Angeles. Mind you, there will be no more postponements. The court will resume at regular time, 9 a.m., 48 hours from such time. Good day, John.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Well, well. Hey, you boys just never give up, do you? Still trying to put me away, huh? Am I right?
They got a 48-hour extension. They're bringing in a new witness.
Ah, commendable. Very commendable. So what? It doesn't matter. In 48 hours, I will be on my way to Europe. Sorry, but my plans just never change.
Our plans never change either, baby. And the only trip you're gonna be taking is behind a row of 3-inch steel bars, and you're not gonna be back for a long time.
Wishful thinking? I hope whoever your witness is has his life insurance paid up. You know, these streets are full of criminal types who can be very dangerous.
The only dangerous criminal we're worried about is you. You can make book on the fact that in 48 hours we're going to rectify that.
Bye-bye, boys. Wish me a pleasant voyage. Tell me about this new witness, Stern.
Well, they're bringing him in from L.A. My guess is that they're going for income tax evasion.
Now, that could only mean that they've persuaded Finley to testify, huh? Baby, how'd you like a nice trip to California?
I'd like Europe a lot better.
Later, baby, later. Finley's in California right now, and he's more important.
California sun wouldn't hurt my tan any.
Okay. Nice going, baby.
Comfortable, fellas?
Figured you wouldn't mind.
You drink that. And I'm gonna throw your ass out that window and watch you bounce.
Hey, what is this, huh? It wasn't our fault they got hit.
Where were you when it happened?
Me, I was at a nearby gas station taking a leak.
Yeah. Those long hours of retiring business. I went out to get a cup of coffee to stay awake.
Who do you assholes think you're talking to? Some deaf and dumb nitwit? I'm gonna have you both cited for negligence of duty and possible bribery. Maybe a few years in the slammer with your friend Rosewald, you'll have time enough to drink your coffee, take a piss, and get your heads out of your asses. Now get out of my sight.
You think they were bought?
No, I'm pretty sure. I better get a hold of Finley in L.A. before he hears about this and panics.
Hello, Finley.
This is the district attorney, Virgil Ryland.
Listen, Mr. District Attorney, I heard about your other two witnesses, and I don't plan to join them, so let's forget about the whole thing, okay?
Look, you can't do that even if you wanted to. Finley, as long as you're alive and Rosewald is free, you're a threat to him. Or have you forgotten that you're his accountant?
Okay, what's your plan?
Simple. After the trial, I'll arrange a new life for you and your family in another country.
Yeah. What's my guarantee I'll get to the trial alive?
My personal guarantee. I'm having someone escort you from L.A. He'll be in touch with you. His name is Crowder.
Okay, I'll do it. God help me.
Crowder? That bum? That ex-cop?
Jonas, just because his methods are unorthodox, that didn't make him a bad cop.
Wherever he goes, there's always trouble and a few dead bodies left behind. Shoot first and ask questions later. He's like a page out of the Old West.
You're right. Yet you've just described the one man that can get Finley here alive. Jesse Crowder.
Yeah. Jess Crowder? Yeah, he's here, but he's busy. Look, fella, I said he's busy. Now, just because you need to talk to him, don't change that situation now. Virgil? That's a funny name for a dude. Are you funny something? Well, a cat with a name like Virgil really must need some help. I'll get him for you.
Throw a punch this side and watch. Black back fist right to the nose. Okay? I'll throw the punch. Go. Nah. Way up. Hard. Ready? Go. That's it. One more time. Ready? Go. That's it. You want to hurt the guy. Now watch. This time you're going to use the side of the hand. Throw the punch. Block side of the hand. See that? Right underneath the chin. Okay? Let's try. I'll throw the punch. No, the other hand. There you go. That's the same thing, way up there. Wind up. Go. That's it. Once more. Come on. Good. Now the other side of the hand, see? This side right here. Okay? That's it. Ready? Blocking with that hand. Ready? Go. That's it. Once again. Ready? Go. That's it. Chop it in there. One more time.
Hard.
That's the idea. Good. Now watch. This time, wrist lock. You grab your opponent's wrist, underneath, over, and grab the hand. See that? Okay. Good. And then underneath this. Watch. Okay? Big circle underneath.
Yes. Hit that? There's this guy named Virgil on the phone.
Yeah. Virgil? Yeah, it's Crowder. Yeah, sure, I'm free. That sounds easy enough. $25,000, standard fee. $40, yeah, that's plenty of time. Right.
So who's the Virgil dude?
Well, that's big stuff in New York, baby.
It sounds like big stuff got big dough. When do you have to go?
Not that soon. Hey, Mac, we store the rolls for a few weeks. Now I'm taking a trip. Have the street machine ready to roll. I might need it. Let's kill some time. Mm-hmm.
Greetings, Jesse. I'd like to have a couple of minutes with you. Pleasure or business?
You can either do it here or downtown, chum. Either way's okay with me.
Still playing a tough cop, huh, Don? You've been Ted's yes man for 5 years. What's the matter, getting to you?
Why, you smart-ass bastard. I'd like to have you along for a couple of hours.
For what? To change your diapers? Now, that's enough, Don. Look, Jesse, about that business in New York. I mean, we know the DA hired you to deliver Finley Toll. So what? Does it bother you that he has more faith in me than the strong arm of the law? That's not the problem.
I don't see why.
We know your tactics. That's why you're not on the force.
Results is my thing. You worry about how to get them. I don't. Well, we'll keep an eye on you anyway.
Yeah, in case you need a real cop.
You do that, but don't get too close. You might get in my way, and I ain't responsible.
Virgil Maxwell sent me. I'm a friend of his.
Come on in. I'll be finished in a minute.
Enjoy yourself?
Yeah, I always do, baby. So you're a friend of Virgil's, huh?
Yeah.
What are you, some kind of thank you present for taking the job?
You could say that. I'm supposed to take some of the meanness out of you. Somebody's already beat me to that.
Really?
Really.
You got wheels?
Yeah, downstairs.
Well, why don't you just go downstairs and wait for me, huh? I'll be down in a few minutes.
You do like quickies, don't you?
Looks like the lady made contact.
Got you a present to remember me by.
I don't think I'm going to need anything to remember you by. That's very nice. Must have cost somebody a pretty penny.
You won't mind.
24 carat?
24 carat with love.
Who is it?
Jesse Crowder. Virgil sent me. Open the damn door.
Where are the rest of the men?
I'm it. Let's move it.
Only one man? Listen, boy, I'm not leaving here without more protection.
You're gonna need protection from me if you don't move it.
are we going? The airport's the other way.
We got company on our tail. Change of plans. You just sit back and shut up.
Look, I'm the state's prime witness, so you better treat me with some respect.
You ain't nothing to me, fatso. Dig it? The only thing I got to do is get you there alive.
Rosewald would love to see me dead. You know why? I know his whole operation. I was his accountant for 15 years. What I know about him will put him away for life.
That was great.
I got it all in my head, right here in my noggin. You know what else? I got a feeling I'm not gonna make it there alive to tell it.
Like I said, I've been out here 3 years in this heat. But I can look at you and tell you from back east. New York, probably. You don't look or dress like anybody from out west, but you're just as pretty. I'm from New York myself. Born in Harlem Hospital. Come out here to get away from the streets. How you, brother? I'm Lockjaw Sampson. I own the place.
Well, that's good. How about some service?
What can I do for you?
Well, my car's running a little hot. Take a look at it.
Yeah, sure, brother.
Excuse me, mister, but I'm trying to figure out how to get to Colorado Springs. Can you help me?
No, lady, I'm busy.
I can't figure it out. I don't know if I can go through Denver or not. I'm confused.
That's your trouble, baby. That's not your blood. Give your mouth a rest. I'm gonna throw you out on it.
I'm hungry. I'm gonna get something to eat.
All right, just hurry up. We're not gonna stay here long. Fill her up. Have the attendant park the car here. I'm going to the head.
Thank you.
All right, Benny, let's move it.
I'm not going with you. I'm turning back. I told you it wouldn't work. You should have listened to me.
You can stay here if you want. I don't give a shit. Make it easy for him.
Wait, you bastard!
Thank you.
Shit!
Very much for the ride.
Sure thing.
It's fine. Thanks.
The fellow you picked up, where'd he go?
He just walked off that way.
Finley! I see him.
think this is? A taxi cab?
Here's $100, lady. Just keep driving.
Are you some kind of criminals?
No.
Are you on the lam?
No.
Then what's with this cops and robbers routine?
I'm just trying to stay alive, lady.
Next plane out is in 4 hours.
What do we do till then? We can't stay out here in the open.
Well, I've got a place at the hotel. You can kill 4 hours there.
Please don't use that word.
Well, that's about as good a place as any.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Make yourself comfortable. I'll be back in a minute.
Nice room.
You decide to be a track star again, Finley, you let me know. When the hell were you going anyway?
Man, I was so scared. I told you, I need more protection. Crowder, level with me. We're not gonna make it, are we?
No, not if you keep pulling silly-ass stunts like that. Next time we separate, you're on your own, Finley.
Okay, okay.
Drink?
Sure.
My name's Alice.
Here's to you, Alice. All right, Fatso, rise and shine. I'd like to thank you for everything, but I think we can make it from here. Bye.
Make a call to a friend who might be down here this weekend. We'll hold up there for a few hours and take a Greyhound from there.
Greyhound? How the hell are we gonna get to New York in 48 hours on a Greyhound?
Don't worry about it, Finley. I'll get you there.
interest in firing. What's this all about, Jesse?
Just another job, Poopsie. That's all I can tell you. Besides, beautiful ladies ain't supposed to know everything.
Well, there's some things I know very well.
How well I remember.
You know, you shouldn't stay there. So long, you might forget.
Well, you're just gonna have to try harder to make me remember, ain't you?
Jesse, there's some men behind you.
Walk slowly into bed. Sorry about this mess.
This is my roommate, Tatsy.
Tatsy? Look, I better be going before the cops come. I'm sure your neighbors have called them by now.
Don't stay away so long, and next time come by yourself.
Oopsie, I owe you one. By my side is where you belong. Let's get finished.
cover.
I'm sorry, I was just gonna ask you a question. Who the hell are you anyway? FBI or CIA?
I'm sorry, lady. I just have sharp reflexes, that's all.
Don't be sorry. Just be prepared to meet me in court. Or, take me to dinner tonight. The choice is yours.
Are you always so delicate?
Depends on the person I'm dealing with. Which will it be?
Either this no-air-conditioned train or you that's making me sweat, Viva. So you're a professional model, huh?
Uh-huh.
On your way to New York for a fashion show. How long you been a model?
I'm through eating, Crowder. But that was a good meal.
Yeah, I can see that.
Think I'll go lie down a while, okay?
Yeah.
Exquisite.
Watching Finley eat gave me heartburn.
What kinds of things do you do for money?
Anything. You name it.
Interesting. What else do you do?
Well, I fashion a few models from time to time.
When you're not knocking people around?
Something like that. You've been asking all the questions. Let me ask one.
Shoot it from the hip, baby.
Are we going to bed? You're a better fashion model than you are a hit lady.
What are you gonna do with me? Please don't kill me.
I'm not gonna kill you, baby. You're too good in the sack for that. I'm just gonna bruise you up a little.
Ah! You bastard! I should have killed you first.
Yeah, baby, but you didn't.
John.
Could you hold it?
No.
All right.
from Paris, gate 8. Flight 26 from Paris, now arriving, gate 8.
Yes, operator, I'll accept a call. What's the matter, Crowder? Problems? Is Finley with you?
Yeah, Finley's okay. My price has gone up to $50,000.
$50,000? Look, Crowder, wait a minute. You agreed to do the job for $25,000.
You forgot to tell me the bad guys will be around every corner. Who knows my travel plans besides you?
No one other than Jonas and myself.
Well, there's a loose screw somewhere. I'm going to find it. I'll take a cab to the hotel. You bring the money there.
Right.
In there.
Dry your hair.
Well, then it looks like your freedom is only a little more right away.
Maybe your freedom is. I don't know about mine.
No wonder they knew where we were. A goddamn homing device in the watch. Come in.
Hello, Jesse.
Virgil? Jonas?
Here's the money. We're gonna make that court date, thanks to you. Where's Finley?
Finley!
About that internal leak. We're sorry, but we're working on it.
No problem. I'll take care of it.
See you later, Jesse. And, thanks.
I'd like to make a reservation. Los Angeles. One way. For me?
Sure, Jess. Made a few phone calls, had it in a flash.
I'll get it.
Yeah, that's where she's staying. I heard she was leaving town today.
Thanks.
Jess, be careful.
No fun being careful, baby.
Jesse, what do you do? I mean, how are you, Jesse? I missed you.
I miss you too, baby. Taking a trip?
Yeah, sunny California wasn't too sunny. I'm on my way to Acapulco.
Here's a going away present for you. I'm returning the watch.
Why, Jesse?
Just didn't get a bang out of it, baby.